Hey everyone. Okay, Aquarius, welcome. For those of you who are new, specifically, hi, welcome to Opal Oracle. Those of you returning, of course, nice to have you. Now, you received a similar message. The first words out of my mouth once I flipped over all your cards were, "What the fuck?" Sorry, don't be concerned or alarmed necessarily. It was just kind of like, whoa, alright, okay. And then we get up to the pinnacle of the situation and we have this. What? We have this, Aquarius. This actually has been interesting. I just got like a shooting pain in my, back. For some of you, this could be the mother of your children. For others of you, this is a conversation with a person that has a child. Obviously, fire signs, Sagittarius, Aries, Aquarius, Leo. We do have Aries on the bottom of the deck. The Five of Cups underneath that. Okay. The Temperance, which is December, underneath that. Okay, Sagittarius. Sagittarius and Aries in between there, Five of Cups. That's love, fire. And that Five of Cups is not a nice card. It's a sad card. So it shows me in one way that there is probably a fire sign in your life, and or obviously part of your chart, yourself, that you where you're hiding your emotions right now, okay? And that's probably why I was just like, what the fuck? Like, because it's not necessarily that any one particular card is like a bad card by any means, but there's a lot going on here. I mean, you have sword, sword, sword on the bottom. That's a lot of thinking, and I see actually that what you want is to not think about it anymore. I see that you're, like, you don't want to think about it anymore. And for you to not think about something, once you're finished, when you're done thinking about it, I guess you really want to think about it before you have a conversation, okay? Which is fine, and that makes all the sense. Because how you feel is that you know how to say it. This is the Ace of Swords and what you know, or rather, excuse me, what you feel. I think it's interesting that you have a feeling in your, well, no, it's not that interesting, you're an air sign. Your feelings are within your mind. It's how you feel your feelings, right? But I see here again that you've been, regardless of this area, someone else, it's always you, you've been hiding your feelings for some time. Now, for some of you, I can see that it's, some of those feelings, some of what is going on, the foundation of the situation is based in sadness. Hear the word Afghan. see, I'm getting all wrapped up in these sword cards. I'm just like drawn in, rolling around, trying to figure it out. What is this? If I mix this with that, like, does that make sense so that I can move, like, up and out, but then I get drawn back into it? So there's something about, okay, during this time, this is the mid-December to beginning of the year-ish, okay? Basically, what it shows me here is you need to get out of your head, honey. If what you want is the truth, then be what it is that you want. Be the truth. You be the truth. You can't make anybody else tell the truth. And in essence, the truth is subjective. Technically. So just be as honest as you can with you about your own shit. Okay, no offense, but I mean, like, when you're kind of having, like, that real conversation with yourself. Okay, like, I heard you can't help anybody out of the cold. You can only be okay with yourself. Okay? It's not to say that you're not supportive of situations or what happened, you know, or the like. It's not about that. But right now, during this time, specifically speaking, has something to do with the reality is that you're learning about actually how to hang on to your energy. Okay? That's what your strength is right now. Is that you can learn to hang on to that energy with inside of you so that you can feel more stable in your day-to-day life and with your relations with other people and not get stuck in your head so much, okay? Because really, this is draining. This is energy sucking. Well, this does take a lot of energy to wield the sword, actually, but it's very positive. But this is a lot of, specifically that, of course, it's just, it's still too much in your head. There's not enough balance here, okay? It's like if this is all air and one earth. So all I picture is like this, like a, I don't know, it's like an air pocket under the soil, and it sort of, it would seem surface, right? Solid for some reason. But if you were to step on it, it would just pop, and there's nothing in there. And I heard it's not habitable. It's not a habitat for anything. I heard that is you. Okay, so, and that goes back to hiding stuff, right? Like putting it, don't do that. If you need to have a conversation, have a conversation. Know that you can have a mature conversation. This is the message from your dark side. This is a message from your shadow side, light side. That's fine. You'll be fine. Both these people are very able to express what it is that they want in ways of passion, in ways of creation, in ways of business. In ways of energy, right? Wands are magic wands. They're energy. Interesting. See, that's what it is once you, okay, that's why, in a way, you're thinking, how am I supposed to have this conversation? What am I supposed to say? What am I going to say? How am I going to say it? I see the part of your weakness is that you've been, whoever you're having this conversation with, in a way, you've known them for a really long time, okay, in some way or in some context or another, some level or another. And I heard you never wanted it to be this way. But you're tired of it being, someone's tired of it being a particular way, so they're trying something new, okay? Because home is important to them. Tradition, stability is important to them, okay? So I guess what it is for some of you, you're afraid to have a conversation in a particular way. Someone's afraid to have a conversation because if they do, they see. I see that it'll affect their home. I see that it'll affect the, their... The two people, will, in a way, are now, let's see what they're looking at. They just don't... They're not going to have the same relationship that they did before, okay? But that's not necessarily a bad thing. The interesting thing about karma, which in essence is everything, at least I can, you know, with humans, wow. Sorry, this kid's just, jeez. Looked fun, you know, like these two kids were playing, they were chasing each other in the snow and like having a snowball fight. But the one that was running away was the one that got hit first, and they didn't fight back, you know. And then the one that actually was chasing. The one that was running away and threw. It's like the one that was running away stopped. And somebody, and in a way, the kid in the back, he like took a cheap shot at him. But because the one that was trying to get away from the situation didn't respond like aggressively, it just sort of. He just sort of like surrendered to it. The one that was attacking, the one that was whatever, throwing this energy at this person, just sort of jaunted off, and then and then they just went their separate ways. I heard it's just there's timing involved here. The queen's actually looking over at... I hope it's not getting too dark, sorry. The queen's actually looking over at the emperor and the wheel of fortune. I was wondering. Wow, right? And the king of wands, which now they're like this. Is looking over at the pool. New journey. A really transformative new journey. Okay. Let's see about what's about another sword. It's a. There's just a, it's a healing, okay? I keep hearing journey and healing. I'm actually interested what comes after that. Because I see here that the queen actually, one of the people actually finds something. Two of Pentacles, Seven of Swords, Two of Cups. I mean, some of you have been lying, but You know, sometimes we just feel stuck, but that doesn't mean that we have to stay that way, okay? I see that in behind. Behind isn't the right word. You just have to face something, okay? For some reason, I also feel like the King of Wands, obviously this can be any fire sign, but technically I think that they're the Sagittarian King, and the Queen of Wands is the Leo King, Queen, rather. So, that could just be part of your chart. I see strongly Aries, Leo, Sag, all fire right here. See how long this is. I totally lost track of time.
Okay. What's that? Oh, shucks.
I mean, something's going to change that affects the fourth house, okay? Home. Something affects home. Something that affects... I mean, yeah. I mean, I heard it's a change in the lovers, it's a change in the wind, it's a change in the lovers. And when I did that and I tapped that twice, this card, the Emperor, with the ten of cups here, okay? Let me see. It's going to be a new analyzation. This is probably what I was thinking is about. The way that you... view your own ability to... I keep hearing... grow, love... And then, as if it was love, grow, grow, love, love, grow, love, grow, grow, love. I don't know if these are other words. Grow, love. I mean, six is a balanced number, but six is the lovers, and it really is about, you know, that's the part of the fool's journey where he has to decide whether he's taking... Which path he's going to choose now. I heard once in a lifetime. The tree said something. I couldn't hear it. What'd you say? Oh. Look, make sure that you look around the corner. Okay, what do they say? Be ahead of the curve? Because if you just look at what it is that you're able to see right now, in a way you're going to feel like you're on the edge of something, it's going to stress you out. Okay, you're not going to feel like you... are stable enough But if you, which I guess I'm going left, technically. So you may find clues like that, but you just have to look at the whole picture, okay? Don't just focus on the edges. You have to focus on the whole picture, and once you do, you'll realize that it's a lot more solid and protected than you think that it is, okay? And that it's, for every winter comes a spring, all right? Every winter comes a spring. Okay. I will see you in the new year. Peace out, pray. Take care of yourself.